Welcome to another exciting video. This video is on a rudiment called the drag, and it's following the video that we looked at with regard to the flam. So here comes the drag the drag lesson. So the drag is another rudiment, as I've just said. Now it's similar to the flam. So the flam, let's have a recap here. The flam is played with a tap on the left and a large stroke on the right. So you get this kind of thing. Okay, but a drag has two notes playing instead of one. So let's go back a minute. The one tap played in the context of a flam, it's called a grace note, okay? There's just one of those. So tap, it's one note, yeah? The difference between the flam and the drag has two grace notes preceding the main note. And you think of it as diddlum, diddlum, diddlum. So when you think of a flam, you think of flam, 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 or plum, plum. Flam, flam, or plum, plum. When you think of a drag, you think of diddlum. So two little notes, diddlum, 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 diddlum. So your primary note is this one, and your two little notes, or your grace notes, are this one. Well, it's this hand, the left hand. That's if you're right-handed. How you treat the two little fast notes, so the two grace notes, is a little bit with the doubles. A technique of doubles, right? So when we looked at the doubles video, we were talking about the rebound. So we take the one stick and just do the double on that stick. So obviously it's not right, right, left, left, or if you were to reverse that, left, left, right, right, it's just two lefts. Using the technique that I talk about in the doubles video. So if you haven't watched the doubles video, just return, just rewind a few videos. Just go back through a few videos and look for the doubles video, and that will show you the technique needed for doubles, right, which in turn will help you with the double left on here. I will say briefly, you rely on a rebound, so you don't do two movements for each note. So I'm not going, I'm just kind of using one stroke, getting two notes from that. But as I say, look back over the doubles video, because that will really help you with that. So basically, there's your drag. So two grace notes, which are little notes, which are played as taps, with the doubles technique in there. So the rebound thing, and then your one main note coming down like this. Diddlum. 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 You can practice them repeatedly. That right hand is pretty free. Just bouncing like that nicely without that going. I'm not lifting it really intentionally with a big lifting motion. It's just bouncing back. When I do one, I start there and end there. So the stick still bounces, but I don't let it come back to do multiple ones, because I'm just doing one, and that could be the situation. You might just have to do it one off, like a. So I should say as well as playing them this way around, this would be called a right hand drag. What determines that as a right-handed drag is the fact that you're coming down on the main note with your right hand. You can obviously play, well not obviously, but you should practice them the other way around, right? So you should practice them coming down with the main note on your left stick, commencing with the two grace notes with the right stick. Same thing, one to one. So your two grace notes, which are created by the tapping position, and now have now shifted onto the right hand, and your main note has now shifted onto your left hand. That's called a left-handed drag, right? Now the thing is, I didn't want to say in the flam video because I just wanted to get you doing it one way round because it's kind of a new thing. But obviously, I keep saying obviously, you can play the flam the other way around, okay? So you've been in the video before you learn a right-handed flam. Sorry, right-handed flam. Now you can do it the other way around to create a left-handed flam. So the left hand now plays the main note, also known as the primary note. You ready? So therefore, the right hand is playing the tap. There you go. So let's recap, okay? Right-handed flam, left-handed flam, one into the other. Right-handed drag, cool. Left-handed drag, one into the other. Which is a nice thing to practice. So that explained. You could practice the two, what will eventually be the fast notes, the grace notes. You could practice those slowly to start with. Especially if you haven't got your doubles up to speed. So if you're still working on your doubles quite slowly, obviously they're going to be kind of that slow when you then apply it to the drag here. But as your doubles get faster, then in turn the one double, so the two taps, the two grace notes within a drag will get quicker. You know, it's all interrelated. So when I did my little bit of playing at the start, I was trying to show you some context, put them in, give them some application, put, you know, play them in context. So I was doing a shuffle kind of rhythm and then a push after a drag. So the push would be on the crash cymbal, the bass drum, so this sort of. So that's an example. You can use them as fill-ins. Which is nice. You can use them in the military thing. So in the flam video, I was showing them as being part of a military kind of context. And I was embellishing like a march thing. In addition to playing flams, I was embellishing it with all sorts of things. I was playing drags, numbered rolls, fives and nines. So let's do that again. Let's play like a military kind of pattern on the snare. And I will use drags, but I'll use other stuff around it, like fives and nine straight rolls, which we'll be looking at in the next video. The next few videos, because before we look at that, I'm going to be looking at something called roughs after this. But let's do a snare pan routine thing with a combination of drags, flams, fives and nines. Ready? I think at the start I was also using it in like a beat. So this is such a commonplace thing to use the drag within like a funk beat. There. The flat. slam is split, the hands are split. They're moving between the snare and the hi-hat. Diddle-um, diddle-um, diddle-um. I use that a lot. A lot of drummers use that, whether they're playing funk, rock or pop. Quite a commonplace thing. So you can see the drag here is useful in contemporary styles. Useful as fill-ins and also useful kind of in the military core music context, you know, like the RAF band snare drummers, the Royal Marine snare drummers. Amazing to watch. So they're very highly skilled. The amount of work or learning you can do just for a snare drum, you wouldn't believe it. You could do 6 hours a day for a couple of years at least, and you'd still only be halfway there to learning, say, all of it. That's talking very, very approximately there, boy. So hopefully that was helpful. Thanks very much, and good night. So what's next? Ruffs is next. I've just said good night and carried on talking. That doesn't make any sense, does it? Right, very quickly. I've done a video on flams earlier. I've now done this video on drags. And the video after this is going to be called Ruffs. So, yeah. Thanks a lot, and this is it now. Good night. Cheers, bye.